For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
So here we are in Havana, Cuba. In fact, we're in the heart of Havana at a main intersection of 23rd and Jota. It's called La Rampa. And this is actually where the protests were supposed to be, or one location. We've been walking all over Havana today, haven't seen a thing. In addition to a call for people to come out on the streets, there was a call for people at 3 o'clock to get out and start clapping. Didn't see or hear any clapping. There was a call to put white sheets outside their windows. We didn't see a white sheet anywhere. All we saw were lots of Cuban flags and some symbols of the revolution. The sense that we get being here is that whether or not people like their government, they know that these protests are only going to lead to division, to chaos, and what they want is to move ahead. In fact, today was the first day that the schools opened for all of the kids after 20 months of COVID, thanks to their own vaccine and a campaign that has vaccinated children from the age of 2 up so that parents could feel comfortable about sending their kids to school. It was also a joyous day because the airports opened up for international flights again for the first time since COVID. And travel, tourism is a major part of the Cuban economy. So to get tourists back in is very, very important. So people are seeing today as this was not the time to call for protests and to create this kind of division and hatred.
Cuba is a beacon of light for progressive people around the world, inspiring freedom fighters from the Americas to Africa to Asia, all the way even in the United States, showing a path of freedom from neocolonialism and exploitation. But every beacon is also a target for those who prefer the darkness. While the U.S. sees Cuba as a slave that needs to return to the plantation, the truth is that Cuba is a nation of 11 million people who will never be enslaved to imperialism again. In fact, the opposite will happen because more and more people are waking up to what needs to happen around the world to their home countries. As people want justice in this country, we want an end to police terror in this country. We want free and quality health care and education for all people in this country. We want to end hunger and homelessness in this country. We must show the world that this country's poor and working class people stand with Cuba and not with the CEOs and bankers who want to overthrow the Cuban government. Hands off Cuba!
Hands off Cuba!
The people united will never be defeated. 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 The people united will never be defeated.
Oh, my God.